Thank you, LAR Tajuk Ashikin, as a moderator for today's webinar session of Malaysia Botanic Garden 2021. National Landscape Department, Ministry of Housing and Local Government, as the organizer of this webinar, would like to extend our gratitude to all speakers and audience for joining us today. It is an honor, and personally, I'm very glad that Dr. Saw Leng Guan, a prominent botanist in Malaysia, is with us today. I believe that Dr. Saw is going to share with us on his experience and expertise on botanic garden development in the country that will inspire us. Thank you, Datuk, for your participation. I would like to extend our sincere thanks to Forest Research Institute of Malaysia, FRIM, for this collaboration. For today's session, FRIM will be represented by Madam Suhaila Mustafa, the head of Kepong Botanic Garden Program. And she will share with us about Kepong Botanic Garden development. And we are fortunate also to have our neighboring country, Thailand, with us today. That is Dr. Watana Thamin, curator of Queen Sirikit Botanic Garden. Thank you and welcome Dr. Watana to this webinar. Dr. Watana is going to guide us to a better understanding about conserving and preserving plants in botanic garden. Yang berbahagia, Dato-Dato, let me enlighten today's webinar with the introductions of National Landscape Department. Malaysian landscape has been globally renowned for its tropical lushness and nature splendor. The government has been very committed in retaining its identity and uniqueness despite the need to develop and evolve. In January 1996, Malaysian government has entrusted the National Landscape Department under the Ministry of Housing and Local Government with the responsibility to transform the country into becoming a garden nation, which set another historical milestone as the nation embarked on the important missions toward a progressive and high-income nation. It also served as a notion to further enliven the greening Malaysian effort. The garden nation is a country where its physical development is balanced with a well-managed green, beautiful and clean environment. It also equipped with outdoor physical spaces that are unique with special qualities and identity. This comprises a cultured and civilized society who appreciate the balance between physical, social, economic, and environmental development. Furthermore, in addressing the issue of climate change, the department is committed to realize Malaysian commitment in international agenda such as Paris Climate Agreement and Sustainable Development Goals. In striving toward this goal, Malaysia is intensifying its green effort to achieve the vision of making Malaysia a beautiful garden nation. And let us put our concerted effort in achieving this goal. This year, I am delighted to announce that the National Landscape Department is celebrating its 25 years of establishment. Various programs and activities has been implemented in conjunction of the celebration. The National Landscape Day 2021 which was celebrated on the 2nd and 3rd of March 2021, and the Malaysia Botanic Garden Webinar 2021 are among the activities that we organized in conjunction with our Silver Jubilee celebration. Yang bahagia, Dato-Dato, ladies and gentlemen, the National Landscape Department has been entrusted to carry 7 main functions, that is, to plan, organize, implement, and supervise landscape development, open spaces, green spaces, and recreational facilities throughout the nation. Legal enforcement, policy, and guideline implementation on landscape to enhance landscape industry and implementations of landscape research program to provide a strong technical expertise and act as an advisory to the government at all levels on landscape-related matters. And also, Landscape Department is entrusted as a National Landscape Accreditation Center. To materialize the role and functions as mentioned, the department has implemented several landscape programs as a sample to be followed by various agencies at federal, state, and local authority level. Among the programs are Public Parks Program. The public park has been perceived as a core element of landscape development as it houses various components and plant composition within one site to benefit and fulfill the recreational demand from the society. In this matter, National Landscape Department has undertaken the responsibility to provide the access for recreational facilities nationwide with the quality and conducive landscape component while emphasizing on the aspect of the overall urban sustainability and greenery, plant and species biodiversity. The development of large-scale public park in the category of federal park is the first effort to be spearheaded by National Landscape Department. Federal park with the minimum size of 250 acres, in which the land belongs to the federal government, its development and management for the park is funded by federal agencies. Bukit Kiara Federal Park, with the area of 317 acres, is the first park developed by the department. The policy of having large-scale park for each state has been adopted, and a few sites in various states have been identified, and among others are in Terengganu, Pahang, and Johor. Urban Landscape Development Program, or better known as Landscape Perbandaran, was initiated with the objective to revitalize urban fabric in order to ensure a sustainable and vibrant living in the city. This program has set out several strategies to provide conducive and high-quality urban green infrastructure throughout integrating public recreational facilities towards seamless interconnected green spaces within urban area. The aim is to intensify urban solution using landscape architecture approach in city revitalization. Landscape Master Plan is another important program carried out by the department. It is a 10-year term comprehensive document, consists of technical details of a study area, space and land use potential, as well as a landscape related issues on site. This written document outlines a recommendation in the form of policy, strategies, guidelines and development order. This written document outline recommendations in the form of policy, strategies, guidelines, and development order. Landscape master plan identifies action plans and area to be transformed into a large-scale functional green spaces, green connectivity in the cities, and identify the most significant and potential landscape protected area to be reserved. The department is not only doing a physical landscape project, but also involved in non-physical project. Under the Promotion and Industry Development Program, a yearly National Landscape Day was held to inculcate love of landscape among our citizens. And the Tree Planting Campaign Program is held to nurture love for landscape culture among Malaysians. The latest program involved the promotion of landscape industry and companies to a few countries abroad. Public park upgrading, landscape maintenance, tree risk management, tree values and inventory, landscape conservation and preservation project, botanic garden development, research and design of landscape technology, are among the program and activities that has been implemented by the department. We formulated a policy to develop 5 botanic gardens by zone throughout Malaysia. The 5 zones identified namely the southern, northern and east coast of Malaysia, Sarawak and Sabah. To date, Johor Botanic Garden, Perak Botanic Garden and Sarawak Botanic Garden has completed, and the most recent development is Sabah Botanic Garden in Kota Kinabalu. National Landscape Policy acts as a pillar for landscape development, and it serves to enhance Malaysia's unique landscape identity. The aspiration can be achieved through the preservation and conservation of natural resources, the implementation of planned development, as well as an effective landscape management system. Policy statement on the importance of botanic garden as part of the greater green infrastructure was mentioned in the National Landscape Policy, that is in Trust 3 of the policy, which stated, create landscape development programs to provide functional and sustainable green infrastructure. In the same document, strategies and action plan on botanic garden was outlined. The strategy says systematically and efficiently plan, implement, and manage green infrastructure to address the issue of global warming and climate change. And the action plan is also stated in that policy saying that develop a public park, federal park, botanic garden and arboretum as a core of urban greening and protections of plant species. According to the National Landscape Policy, botanic garden was defined as a park that consists of collections of various plants planted and retained in its original natural form, and the plants are recorded, exhibited, and studied to enhance its uniqueness. It also used as a resource for passive recreation. It is also stated that botanic garden development that based on local biodiversity and uniqueness and being recognized globally need to be developed in Malaysia. The policy emphasizes on the importance of plant collection diversity, local culture uniqueness, characteristic, topography and landscape character of the site, that must be taken into consideration in planning, development and management of botanic garden. The development of policies aim to ensure Malaysia Botanic Garden to be recognized by international bodies such as Botanic Garden Conservation International, BGCI, and International Union for Conservation of Nature. The visions aim to ensure that botanic gardens become a sustainable institution and resource center for biodiversity of Malaysian plants and showcasing for scientific research that based on local identity, civilization, culture and richness. Based on that policy, botanic gardens development in Malaysia should focus on four main principles. The first principle is to conserve and preserve biodiversity of plant species originated from Malaysia. Diversification of plant species must be conserved and preserved as a national treasure and heritage to be inherited for our future generation. With rapid development, urbanization and loss of biodiversity caused by climate change, botanic gardens should have the capacity to collect and plant as many species as they can, based on the geographical zone where the botanic garden is located. At this point, botanic gardens should become a resource center for plant conservation, research and education. The second principle is to inculcate the conservation culture among citizens and society. Conservation of existing high-value natural resources and biodiversity must be implemented with the involvement of people, especially from the local community. Conservation culture are crucial to ensure the public have high interest and love towards plants and natural environment. To generate the importance of biotechnological industry by making botanic gardens a center for plant species is the third principle of botanic garden development. The effort can contribute and generate economic benefit to biotechnological industry through plant species genetic bank and productions of natural biotech product. The fourth principle is to make botanic garden as the source of social and economic growth for the local community. Social integration can be achieved through allocation of spaces and recreational facilities via the increase of social interaction. On the other hand, local economic growth can be stimulated by creating job opportunities and economic activities in tourism, horticulture and landscape sector.
Yang bahagia, Datuk-Datuk, ladies and gentlemen, it is not complete when we talk about botanic garden without looking into the direction put forward by the Botanic Garden Conservation International, BGCI. As we all know, BGCI is an international and independent organization that links the botanic garden of the world in a global network for plant conservation. BGCI is highly dedicated to plant conservation and environment education with a mission to mobilize botanic garden and engage partner in securing plant diversity for the well-being of the people and planet. With the aim to promote and develop an efficient, cost-effective and rational approach to plant conservation in the botanic garden, the BGCI network of botanic garden includes global significant living plants collection,
world-class seed bank, glass house, and tissue culture infrastructure, and technical knowledge network covering all aspects of plant conservation policy, practice, and education. For a park or garden to be recognized as a botanic garden, BGCI has put levels of standard to be followed as for a park to be recognized as a botanic garden, BGCI has put level of standard to be followed, that is an underlined scientific basis for collections, proper documentation of collections, monitoring and long-term maintenance of plants in the collections, adequate labeling of plants, communications of information to other gardens, institutions and public, promoting conservation through extensions and environmental education activities, undertaking a scientific and technical research on plants, conserving rare and threatened plants in ex situ collection and whenever possible in their natural habitat, compliance with the international and national regulation frameworks such as United Nations Convention on Biological Diversity and Convention on International Trade in Endangered Species of Wild Flora and Fauna. Lastly, is adoptions and promotions of sustainable practice such as renewable energy, water conservation, and waste recycling. Apart from plant conservation, BGCI also emphasized that botanic gardens should play an important role in international conventions such as the Sustainable Development Goals. The SDG framework provides helpful points of reference to demonstrate the fundamental importance of plants for the planet. Our country is blessed with abundance of flora and fauna. The flora of Malaysia consists of approximately 15,000 species of vascular plant. Globally, Malaysia is ranked 14th in terms of species of vascular plant. However, the nation's flora and fauna are under severe threat and has experienced about 70% depletion of its original growth, according to the International Union of. However, the nation's flora and fauna are under severe threat and has experienced about 70% depletion of its original growth, according to the International Union for Conservation of Nature, Red List, Malaysia has 686 endangered plant species. Most of the flora can be found in the dense rainforests of Malaysia, and some species are planted in the public spaces such as public park, landscape corridor and botanic garden. To date, Malaysia has 10 botanic gardens, namely Penang Botanic Garden, Perak Botanic Garden, Kepong Botanic Garden, Perdana Botanical Garden Kuala Lumpur, Rimba Ilmu, Universiti Malaya, Putrajaya Botanical Garden, National Botanical Garden Shah Alam, Johor Botanic Garden, Sarawak Botanic Garden and Labuan Botanical Garden. Apart from that, we also have arboretum and agriculture park, such as Sabah Agriculture Park and Sandakan Rainforest Park. And I believe some universities also have their own conservatory. All these parks are developed and managed by different agencies or government bodies. However, at national level, we see this. All these parks are developed and managed by different agencies or government bodies. However, at national level, we see there is a need for a comprehensive strategy to ensure the botanic garden development are successful. As federal agency, National Landscape Department would like to suggest a few strategies in botanic garden development. That is to ensure our resources on botanic garden development is capitalized to its fullest capacity and potential. First, it is crucial for a botanic garden to have a proper and organized platform to channel our options and consent to the policy maker. Collaboration with public agencies, institutions of higher learning, research institute is needed to strengthen the networking with a proper framework for an action plan. It is crucial for a botanic garden to have a proper and organized platform to channel our options and consent to the policy maker. Collaboration with public agencies, institutions of higher learning, research institute are needed to strengthen the networking for a proper framework. The webinar that we are having today is one of our initiative that to strengthen the networking. We need to have more programs and activities to be conducted in future to make our presence visible to the stakeholder and public. We also need more players to come forward and to take active and constructive part in this networking. Our aim is to have a national blueprint on botanic garden produced by Malaysian Botanic Garden Network. Botanic Garden Advisory Council is needed to be formed to ensure proper coordination between stakeholders at federal, state, and local authorities, as well as the related bodies. The advisory council will ensure the directions on development and management of botanic gardens will be comprehensively implemented. The functions of the advisory council are to advise federal and state government on matters related to botanic gardens and plant species conservation. The vision of national landscape policy, national policy on biodiversity, and other related policy on botanic garden and plant conservation can be well coordinated to endorse standards, guidelines, manuals and research related to botanic garden, to endorse recommendation on botanic garden planning and development, to implement legal matters related to botanic gardens development and plant species conservation. Malaysia are blessed with abundant plant species that are native to our geographical zone of area. The Peninsula of Malaysia has around 8,200 species, while Sabah and Sarawak has around 12,000 species. As mentioned earlier, the botanic garden development
must be based on local biodiversity and uniqueness, and therefore it is important for each botanic garden to have a special collection of plant species that exist in their territory. Conservation of plants under IUCN Red List and Malaysia Red List endemic to their landscape and geographical zone will spur interest and uniqueness of each botanic garden. Furthermore, conservation program, either in situ or ex situ, should be designed based on good science and data. This required the collective effort of all related agencies and organizations. Malaysia Botanic Garden have significant seed bank, gene bank, and living collections that are essential for managing the risk of species loss in the wild. The collections are vital. Malaysia Botanic Gardens has significant seed bank, gene bank, and living collections that are essential for managing the risk of species loss in the wild. These collections are vitally important for the preservation of plant species. One of the strategic action plans is to make information available and easily accessible by creating a communication and information sharing tools for Malaysia Botanic Garden. These tools will identify, prioritize, and communicate in the perspective of plant conservation and research needed based on the national interest. Managing the public institutions such as Botanic Garden require stable financial resources for the development, management, and maintenance. With current scenario, the Botanic Garden must have a comprehensive business plan to generate income and optimize expenditure. At planning and design stage, landscape architect must incorporate design elements that can minimize management and maintenance costs, and design approach as such. At planning and design stage, landscape architect must incorporate design elements that can minimize management and maintenance costs. Design approach such as nature-based solution, biophilic design, and maintenance-free concept must be considered while designing a sustainable botanic garden. The strength of a garden are in plants collections and horticulture research, where these resources can be commercialized to leverage intellectual property with strategic partners in industry, such as a biotechnology and cosmetic industry, in the productions of natural biotech products. Commercial consultancy and professional services provision is another opportunity that Botanic Garden can offer to strengthen income generation. Apart from that, engaging the corporate sector in the trust capacity or CSR to fulfill social and environmental responsibility commitment is another option for revenue collection. The sixth strategy is Botanic Garden as a leading center for learning in plant science and conservation. Botanic Garden must facilitate connections between people, the botanical and the natural world by expanding public program to connect their work in horticulture, landscape, science, and research. Such program will enhance understanding and appreciation
for plants in everyone's life. Besides that, engagement with a wider community is valuable as a platform to share stories about plants and further enhance understanding and appreciation of the importance of plants to the livelihood of the society. Lastly, botanic garden should show a distinctive design and plant collection. Botanic garden must facilitate public enjoyment, education, conservation, and research by creatively create a destination garden. This garden should have facilities and ambience as a hub for learning and gaining botanical knowledge, a place to see plant grow, and a haven for biodiversity. Furthermore, botanic garden also should emphasize on the unique and outstanding landscape architectural design based on landscape character, visual quality, tangible and intangible resources of the site with an adaptation to tropical climate splendor. Yang bahagia, Datuk-Datuk, ladies and gentlemen. Lastly, I hope we can have a strong strategic networking and commitment toward achieving the same goal for Botanic Garden in Malaysia, and also connecting all Botanic Gardens in other parts of the world. Attention to technological advancement and innovation should be our priority in Botanic Garden development. It is a very privilege to have all of you today in this webinar. Thank you. I hope the deliberation that we have on this topic will create a strong partnership and collaboration among us in the future. Wabillahi taufiq wa hidayah. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.